Cayman Compass sports journalist Seaford Russell here, and we're joined by the Cayman Islands Football Association president, Mr. Alfredo Whittaker. Mr. Whittaker, thank you so much for joining me, sir. We know that our national football team will be traveling in a matter of days to compete in the World Cup qualifiers in their first match against Suriname. Just walk me through the process of what that has been like, a whirlwind, I could imagine, with COVID-19 playing such a major factor in trying to get everything organized.
Well, we only have hours before our travels now. And first of all, thanks for giving me the opportunity to join you here. This has been one of the most difficult travels to organize in my entire life. Thank God and for the assistance of our head coach, Benjamin, our general secretary, Marcos Tinoco, and some other people overseas. Mm-hmm. We're pretty much ready to go now. We're finalizing small details, but I could tell you I'm very, very, very happy and proud to say that yes, the Cayman Islands Football Association would be participating in this first round of World Cup qualifiers.
Absolutely. And we know that there was some difficulty getting the game between Canada official, but we broke the news recently that that game is in fact now official and you guys will be traveling to Florida to play against Canada. What was the process like in trying to get that game, and why was it so difficult for that game to come to fruition?
Well, reason number one is our COVID regulations, that at no point I would try for the government to give us a break on it. I enjoy very much, and I think all of us here in Cayman enjoy very much living the way we are. And we will not jeopardize it. Mm-hmm. For a game of football. So the first process was to get in touch with U.S. Soccer, come to a compromisation with them. That is a lot. They ask for a lot, getting all of the permissions and then mm-hmm. securing a venue where we could have the game. Initially, we was looking at the Orlando City Stadium, and the prices wasn't the best for us. We do not allow to have spectators, so we decided to go with IMG, and that was more feasible for us. So that's where we are. But our travels is a nightmare. We depart here on Saturday. We overnight in Miami. We depart Monday morning to Curacao. Mm-hmm. And once we get to Curacao, we have a charter flight that will take us to Suriname. Upon arrival in Suriname, we go into a little bubble. We already have that arranged. Right. So we get tested again the day before the match. We play the match, and the departure would be again on a charter flight directly from Suriname to Sarasota, where we're going to be staying for our mm-hmm. for our game against Canada, and then return to Grand Cayman on the 31st. Once again, thanks to Cayman Airways for accommodating us, because initially our flight was split, one group traveled before and one after.
Right.
They managed to get us all together to return on the 31st. So that is our journey.
You mentioned that bubble, and you mentioned the testing that will be taking place in Suriname. God forbid one of the players do contract the virus that is around the world right now. What is going to happen in terms of playing the game, and what will happen with that specific player?
In this case, if it happened in Suriname, we already have plan A, B, and C. I would stay behind with the, hopefully it's not me, and hopefully it's no one, right? I would stay behind with the player. We would do our quarantine.
Right.
Then we would travel to Guyana. Mm-hmm. And then from Guyana, we'd be traveling to Florida on American Airlines that is flying I think it's three times a week to Guyana. Mm-hmm. We'd be returning on that flight to Florida, and then obviously back to Grand Cayman. So we have options. All of that have to be in place before our travels, and we have to remember that Suriname also is in lockdown.
Right.
So that's the reason why we chartered a flight from Curacao to Suriname. Once we get there, we know exactly what is taking place, the hotel where we're staying at. We have a floor that is just for our national team. Transportation, obviously, just for our national team. Testing before the game, one day before the game. And after the game, we back to the hotel, back to our little bubble. Early morning, airport, charter flight, back to Florida, back in our little bubble. So I'm confident. This group of players that we have with our national team are so responsible.
Yep.
that thumbs up for them. A part of being very young, they're very, very serious about their national team, and they're very professional, so it's good.
Yeah, and having known most of the players that play on the national team, I can definitely agree with what you are saying. However, there's a lot of traveling going on. Do you guys have something in place for when the guys return? Will they go into quarantine back home again, or will they get right back out into the real world? Because I would assume that some of the jobs of these guys are going to give them a hard time, employers, etc., staying away for so long.
Yeah, I could tell you at this point, Seaford, that every single employee, and forget at the beginning, thanks to them also, every single employee, I'd say yes.
Nice.
To the players that are traveling with the national team. Upon return, some players and some staff already have the two vaccination, so they would do the 10 days that is changed. Others, unfortunately, would do 14 days. But when we return, we go to our quarantine. We go to the government facility to do our quarantine. We're not breaking the Cayman Islands. Yeah. COVID regulations, we're not into that. We're going to continue to work with our government that have us safe. So whatever they put in place, we just follow orders.
Nice. There's a lot of traveling. There's a lot of stayover. There's a lot going on. Where's all the funding for this coming from? Is this a partnership that you guys have joined hands with the government, or is this solely financed by the Cayman Islands Football Association?
I would say at this point, it's solely financed by the Cayman Islands Football Association. At the beginning of my 4 year, when I was elected president of this association, I promised the players a part of compromising with the clubs. I promised the players that every single tournament, one way or the other, we would be representing. So we find a way. I could tell you from day one to where we are right now, we haven't missed one tournament. We haven't missed one friendly match. Mm. We haven't missed absolutely nothing that they had put out there. So I continue that way. The money that we receive from FIFA and CONCACAF will be invested in football, national team, players, and obviously staff. Yeah. And that's where the money should go, and that's where we're going. And we will see results very soon.
You speak about those results. I mean, the big question out there in everyone's mind at this point in time is, will the underdogs rise to the occasion in their group matches? I mean, they're taking on an absolute mammoth in Canada, and you know, what are your expectations of the team? Do you think that we can pull a rabbit out of the hat here?
We taking on some big games, right? Suriname-based players come from Europe.
Yeah.
They play Champions League, they play big Premier League teams in different countries around the world. The Canadians, we know exactly who they are. Bermuda, they have a very strong team. Mm-hmm. That also the base players are in England, in Europe, and Aruba that have a mix.
Right.
I'm very confident. I'm not going to tell you that we're going there and we're going to beat them 5-0, 6-0, but we're going to give them a run for the money. The most important part of this new era in football that I call is that when you have little boys like Justin Biles, Justin is a little 16-year-old,
mm-hmm.
right? Then you have Jackson is another little 16-year-old.
Carcono.
Yeah, Jackson Carcono mm-hmm. is a little 16-year-old. And they already start to follow up in the process that we call, right? They had the opportunity to play with the U14,
mm-hmm.
U15, U17, a little bit with the U20s, and now they're with senior national team. Yes. Our age is pretty much a mix with U23 and a U20. So now we start to see, and we will see progress. Now, good luck next 2 years facing off the Cayman Islands, because I tell you, it's not gonna be an easy thing, right? So we expect, and we're going to give the young players, the new national team, senior men national team, the opportunity for them to grow, to get mature, to get these experience, and for them to start to show their real talent. Those that was part of the national team that didn't have that little bit of, not quality, mm-hmm. because they had a lot of quality, but they didn't have that national team requirement on and off the field, that commitment. We really don't miss them,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
I think they're going to be missing us. So now it's time for these young little boys to go out there, represent the country and shine. So everybody happy.
Yep.
It's a win-win situation.
Mr. Whittaker, I do appreciate your time. Thank you so much for joining me here. And best of luck to the team, you know, on their travels and hopefully health-wise everything goes well as well. Cayman Compass, Seaford Russell Jr. reporting.